Good morning. I'm Dr. Mobola Jeffries. By the grace of God, I'm a family doctor in the United Kingdom, and I'm the host of Thy Precious Jewels, a Christian women ministry. This morning, I would like to discuss with you something that has been very strong on my heart for the past few years. It is the state of our health as Christians. In the early years of being born again, one of the thoughts I had and one of the convictions I had at that time was that I didn't really need to do much about my health because Jesus paid the price for my health and for my healing on the cross. But when I came across a scripture in 3 John, it startled me and it emphasized to me that God has given me responsibilities regarding my health. The scripture says that I desire above all things that you prosper in your health as your soul prospers. I had a read of this particular scripture in different versions, and I think it was in the Common English Bible version. It says that I desire that you prosper within your physical body as your soul has been prosperous. A lot of us are prosperous within our soul. A lot of us feel right within our spirit. A lot of us have a beautiful relationship with God, but we've got disease within our bodies. Now, we hide under the pretense that Jesus has paid the price and we give all the responsibilities to him to sort our bodies out. I was sharing with my husband yesterday the number of young African men and women who have problems with their kidneys. One of the reasons why this is happening in this age is because, one, growing up, we belong to the generation of children who were given native herbal concoctions. These drinks did not have any dose, and it was never really found out what the effect of the combination of leaves that they gave you would cost you. So by the time you're 6 years old and you've had quite a few of these herbal concoctions, you may have had an underlying kidney problem that you're not even aware of. Okay, years down the line, you develop a headache, you develop a malaria, and your parents take you to a neighborhood nurse and they give you some medication. At times, they give you injections. Now, most of the times, they don't even find out whether this suits your body or it doesn't. And I believe that we've lost quite a lot of children as a result of this. Now, as you get older and you become independent, you develop a headache, you walk to the chemist, you purchase something from over the counter, you never find out what you're taking, you never find out whether it is good for your body or not. There are some medications that you shouldn't be having, depending on how your liver is, depending on how your kidneys are. But we never really find out. We just get these things and we swallow them. Some people outrightly refuse to go to the doctors because they believe that Jesus has paid the price. It is stupidity that you do not monitor and manage your health because Jesus paid the price. When you go to bed at night, you lock your gates. Why do you bother to do that? Jesus paid for your protection. He paid for you to be kept safe. Why do you bother to shut the door? Why do you put security gates on? Why do you have passwords on your phone? Why do you lock your car when Jesus has already paid the price for you to be secure? You need to secure your body. You need to go for regular checkups. You need to have blood tests done. You need to have your cervical smear. You need to have your blood sugar tested to make sure that you're not diabetic. All these things God expects you to do. God said, I desire above all things that you prosper in your physical health as your soul prospers. Most of us, our souls are prosperous. We're in tune with God. We can hear from God. But unfortunately, your body will fail you if you don't take care of it. Yes, you can be hearing from God. God can even tell you when you're going to die because you've refused to take care of your body. If you're 8, I would say normally 30, 35 and above, go get your blood pressure checked. Some of us don't even know what conditions run in our family and how we can manage them. Some of us eat anyhow. You see some people eating, you know they cannot live long. Everything goes into their mouth. Watch what goes into your mouth. That is what goes to your heart. That's what goes to your liver. That's what goes to your kidneys. Watch what medications you take. God has given you the responsibility to take care of yourself. Make sure you do it. Don't quote scriptures at me. The scripture is there, yet you lock your door at night. God expects you to use your sense to take care of the body he has given you. When your spirit departs to go to God, your body will be useless. So take good care of that body. We've heard of many people whose spirits are sound, but their bodies fail them. So before you give yourself medication, find out what it contains. Find out whether your kidneys and your liver are able to tolerate it. Before you give your children medication, find out what it contains. Don't just accept prescriptions from people, from doctors, from nurses. Ask them, what does this contain? What should I expect to happen to me as a result of this medication? Any doctor who does not wish to answer that question, they're not really professional. That's the truth. So I'm going to charge you today. Don't let your body fail your spirit. Take care of your body. Take care of the house that God has given you here on earth, so you can be alive and you can live long to enjoy all the benefit that God has for you here. Once again, this is Dr. Omobola Jeffries, the host of Thy Precious Jewels. Have a lovely day. And if this video has taught you something new, please go ahead and share. God bless you.